Hello, this is William from Visual Components. In this video, I'm going to show you how to animate the camera of a 3D world during a simulation using Python API. To get started, clear the 3D world of all components, and I'll go to my eCatalog panel, expand Models by Type, click Demo Layouts. I'll now search for a machine tending layout, which is this item here. I'll drag the layout into the 3D world and just wait for the layout to load. And here we go. So when I start the simulation, I want to have a left top view right here. Let's actually center our view on the conveyor here. And now let's add this as a view for the layout. In the 3D World toolbar, I'll click the View Editor and add this as a new view and rename it to be View 01. I'll now zoom in towards the conveyor. I'll add this as my next view, and I'll call it View 02. From here, I want to rotate the camera, zoom out, and get a better look at the robot and this machine here. I'll add this as View 03, View 03, and then I want to rotate the camera to get a better view of this machine here. I'll add this as my fourth view, so View 04. I then want to rotate the camera to get a better view of this machine, and I will call that View 05. So right now I have five custom views for this layout, which I can save with it. To animate the camera using Python API, we have to create a view animator, and that program we write for the camera can be saved with this layout. I'll now go to the Modeling tab. If you don't have access to Modeling tab, you can create an add-on to complete the rest of this tutorial. From here, you could either create a new component, but I'm going to select the Robot Manager here in the 3D world. I'll now go to the Behaviors drop-down menu and create a Python script behavior. Let's now make the text in the editor bigger. We don't need these lines of code. I will delete them. And to create the view animator, we have to get the application object. All right, app equals get application. And using the application object, we have to create a layout item called view animator. So to see what I'm talking about, let's go to the Help tab, then access the Python API reference. From here, I'll go to VC Application, then to Methods, scroll down to find the section called Layout Item. And what you want to do first is try to find the layout item by name. If it doesn't exist, then you have to create it. So here you can see a link to the layout item constants. So if I click it, you can see the type you have to create is called View Animation. And that is a class called VC View Animation. So if I click this link, you get a section of how the animator works. So it contains a program similar to how the robot programs are structured. There's a program, a scope, a routine that can contain statements. So the statements you can create are view and delay statements. So what view you want for the camera and how long it takes to get there and whether or not you want to delay before going from one view to the next view. So you can see you have access to the camera's program, and then you have an example here. One reason I access the help file is because here's a really simple code example I can just copy and paste in the script. So I'm actually going to copy this here and then paste it into my script. And we can see we create a method called createViewAnimation. We get the application object, and then we try to find that layout item. If we don't find it, then we create it. We get the program of the camera, the main routine, and we clear it of all statements. From there, we create a view statement. The delay property for a view statement is its transition, or how long it takes the camera to move to that view. So this is the animation part of the statement. So let's now change the view that we're referencing to view 01, because the statement can reference your layout views, which we created here in the view editor. We then create a delay statement of 4 seconds and before we go to view 2. So let's actually change this to be view 02. And what's happening here is there's a delay of 4 seconds and then the camera will start moving to view 02, and it will take 4 seconds for the camera to get there. And this is all based in simulation time, by the way. Let's compile our code. We don't get any errors, so that's good. I will minimize the script. And what we expect to happen when we start the simulation is that the camera should move to that first view we created, wait about 4 seconds, and then go to the second view we created. Run the simulation, and the camera's animating out, and at 4 seconds we're at that first view, wait 4 seconds, and now go to the next view. And that's what happens. So we probably want to go there earlier. Let's reset and go back to our script, and let's modify everything just a bit. So let's actually get the statements we need for our other views. I'm going to copy this code block here for a delay and a view. I'll then paste that into the script 3 times. So we start at view 01, then go to view 02. Let's now go to view 03, then to view 04. And I'm going to correct the indentation here. And then let's correct this, and then last we want to go to view 05. So if I compile the code, let's now see what happens. Run the simulation, we go to the first view, so far so good. We're then going to have a delay of 4 seconds, the camera will take 4 seconds to go to the next view, there'll be another delay before we go to the next view. Ooh, very nice, I like it. Another 4 seconds, camera should start moving. There we go. All the way around. Oh, da baby. And then another 4 seconds, and we go to this view. Great. So let's reset. And now go back to our script. And when we start the simulation, we probably don't want to move to view 01. We just want to snap there, be that our first view. So to do that, we can change the delay or the transition to be 0 seconds. Compile the code. Minimize the script. And now when I run the simulation, bam, we're right there in view 01. Wait 4 seconds, go to view 2. The robot now picks up the part. And you probably want to adjust the times to make the simulation look the way you want to. But this is looking good so far. We probably need more delay there before we go to this view. And we probably want to wait till the robot puts a part in the machine before we start rotating the camera again. So if we reset and go back to our script. You could, in some cases, get rid of these delays if you don't want to stop the camera, but hopefully you understand how the view animator works, and if you want, you can continue to customize this layout. Alright, this concludes the video. If you have any more questions, please feel free to visit our forum at forum.visualcomponents.com, and I hope you have a wonderful day.